Yahweh Kanan, Ban Yahawada, Ban Yasha'Allah. And I'm coming in with another GMS motivation that we actually do weekly. Different topics from the brother Aina. And before I go into the topic, I'm going to go into what the topic is. It's 2 Thessalonians 2, 7 through 8. For the mystery of iniquity does already work. Only he who now letteth will let till he be taken out of the way. And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy the brightness of his coming. So just to go into that, break it down a little bit, the mystery of iniquity is Esau, the devil, the old serpent, which is the Roman Empire, which is the establishment of the Alexander the Great, the Macedonia, who set up the first empire of the Edomites, out of coming out of being Esau, which is known as Edom, which is the dukes, which is being which is Aldumium, which is Petra, which is one of y'all ancient king cities, so forth, which being basically reestablished under Alexander the Great, which, just to go there just a little bit before I go to it, it's in Maccabees 1 and 1, and this is why they took the apostles out of the Bible. Maccabees 1 and 1, and it happened after that, Alexander son of Philip the Macedonian, who came out of the land of Kintum, had spent Darius, king of Persia, and Mede, that reigned in his stead the first over Greece, and made many wars and won many strongholds through the kings of the earth, and went through the ends of the earth, and took spoils of many nations, and so much as the earth was quiet before him, whereupon he was exalted, and his heart was lifted up. And he gathered a mighty stronghold, and ruled over countries and nations and kings, and became tributaries unto him. And after these things he fell sick, and perceived that he should die. Wherefore he called for his servants, such as were honorable and had been brought up with him from his youth, which is, was his four generals, like Ptolemy, Lysimachus, I'm not saying them right, Seleucus, and Antigonus. I didn't pronounce them exactly right, but I got them written down. Wherefore he called his servants, such as were honorable, had been brought up with him from his youth, and parted his kingdom among them, which he has yet set alive. So Alexander reigned 12 years and then died, and the servant bell ruled everyone his own place. And after his death, they all put crowns upon themselves. So did their sons after them many years, and evil will multiply in the earth. Yeah, and evil will multiply upon the earth. Because they are known, Esau is known as the border of wickedness. That's why I say wickedness multiplied upon the earth. So this Genesis, I'm going to take it back from the beginning. Genesis 27 and 35. Genesis 27 and 35. It said, and he said, thou brother came with subtlety and has taken away thou blessing. And this is the blessing that Isaac gave Esau and Jacob. And he said, is not thou rightly named Jacob? For he has supplanted me these two times. Why? Because Esau came out the woods from hunting, and he was faint, and he sold his birthright to his brother Jacob for a red pottage of meat. He took away my birthright, and behold, now he has taken away my blessing. And he said, hast thou not reserved a blessing for me? And Isaac answered and said unto Esau, behold, I have made him thou Lord, and all his brother have I given to him for service, and with corn and with wine have I sustained him. And what shall I do now unto thee, my son? But Esau said unto his father, hast thou but one blessing my father? Bless me, even me also, my father. And Esau lifted up his voice and wept. And Isaac his father answered and said unto him, behold, thy dwelling shall be the fatness of the earth. That's why Esau the white man from Alexander the Great all the way until today has come past and compassed the whole earth, and of the dew of heaven from above. And that's why to fly or to have anything satellites out of space, not only do you got to speak English, but all Edomites run all that. The dark nations don't run nothing. From Japheth to the 12 tribes of Israel to Moab, Ammon, to Ishmael, to the Media Persians, nobody. Dwell of heaven from above, and by thy sword shall thou live. And how did he get all this? By thy sword. And shall serve thy brother, and it shall come to pass when thou shalt have the dominion, meaning when orders, you break free and you get the rulership, that thou shalt break his yoke from off thy neck. And Esau rebelled back in the time of King David. So forth, but I had to get that out of Kings. But to keep this short and sweet, I'm just going to paraphrase a lot of stuff. So when you get all the way up to Psalms 83 and 1, he made another trick. Psalms 83, 1. Keep not thou silent, O God, hold not thou peace, and be not still, O God, for lo, thy enemies have made a tumult, and they that hate thee have lifted up the head. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people and consulted against thy hidden one. They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance. For they have consulted together with one consent. They have confederate against thee, the tabernacles of Edom. See that? And it goes further into the Ishmaelites and the Moabites and the Hagarines. But we're going to stick on Edom. Edom was the first nation that was called. And who was that? That's our paternal brother, going back from Esau and Jacob, and that birthright. Well, let me go back to it. Genesis 27 and 41. And Esau hated Jacob because of the blessing wherewith his father blessed him. And Esau said in his heart, the days of mourning for my father are at hand. Then will I slay my brother Jacob. See that? So that's what Esau in his spirit was, to slay his brother Jacob. So what did he have no problem do? Making sure that the 12 tribes of Israel had no more remembrance, they heritage, they nationality, because that's the key to break everything, to expose who this person of iniquity is. And not only that, but to bring everything back to our remembrance, which I'm gonna go back further into that. And yes, he have already did all the works, and I'm gonna show you some of the works he have done, which 2 Thessalonians 2:7 and 8 was speaking of. Ezekiel 35 and 1. Ezekiel 35 and 1. Moreover, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Son of man, set thou face against Mount Seir, and prophesied against it. Now, why did it bring up the ancient empire of Mount Seir that I'm speaking on today, which is these Caucasian Edomites? It's because that's one of the ancient cities that goes back to Esau and Jacob. And say unto it, thus said the Lord God, behold, O Mount Seir, I am against thee, and I will stretch out my hand against thee, and will make thee most desolate. And that's them ICBM missiles. I will lay thou cities waste, and thou shalt be desolate, and thou shalt know that I am the Lord, because thou hast had a perpetual hatred. And Esau, the white man, the devil, the Caucasian, the cave dweller, have shown us here the 12 tribes of Israel all over the world, not only just in door to Babylon, all over the world, that he hate us through his institutions and his strongholds that he has built up to wage war on his brother, which is Jacob. Perpetual hatred, and has shed the blood of the children of Israel by the force of the sword. See that? And that's what he's been doing. He said in his birthright that he was going to have that sword and be able to use it. And he's been doing it ever since, from the Gatling gun to Gad to the regular gun with us here in America. That's being used on the consistent stroke. Sword in the time of their calamity and the time they had iniquity had an end. Therefore, as I live, said the Lord, I will prepare thee unto blood, and blood shall pursue thee. Said thou hast not hated blood, even blood shall pursue thee. And America is defiled, has a lot of blood that's crying unto Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah. Thus will I make Mount Seir most desolate, and will cut off, and will cut from it him that passeth out and him that returneth. And I will fill his mount with the slain man, and thou hills, and thou valleys, and thou rivers, thou shalt fall that are slain with the sword. I will make thee perpetual desolation, and thou city shall not return. For you shall not know, and ye shall know that I am the Lord, because thou hast said, these two nations and these two countries shall be mine. Right? They took Jerusalem for us in 70 AD under the Flavian dynasty, when Vespasian, Titus, Demetrius, brother, which was Edomites, which was the Roman Empire, after coming from Alexander the Great, from Maccabees 101, from Antiochus Epiphany, has took our nation from us. And in Psalms 83, they made sure that Israel wasn't even no more remembered. That's why we came over to the cargo slave ship in America. But they do the Jew, they hung them up and beat them and gave them a new language, a new culture. What did they do to Gad here? The canary effect. Killed the Indians, saved the book. It has conformed us into their society, so they Hellenized us. These two nations and these two countries shall be mine, and we will possess it, whereas the Lord was there. And now you got Esau, the Amalek Jews over there, claiming that they are the Jew. Therefore, as I live, said the Lord God, I will even do according to thou anger and according to thou envy, which thou hast used out of thou hatred against them, and I will make myself known among them. And see, that's that destroying them with the brightness of my coming, which is Yahweh Hashem Abishai coming back and those chariots of Israel. When I have judged thee, and thou shalt know that I am the Lord, and that I have heard all the blasphemy which thou hast spoken against the mount of Israel, saying, they are laid desolate, they are given us to consume. And right, y'all, the Zionist Jews paid for the boat to come get us from the transatlantic slave trade, knowing that we were the 12 tribes of Israel, and shipping Gad and shipping Issacharite back and forth from Britain and Spain, from America, and so forth. They knew, like, this is the Lord people. Because Christopher Columbus knew about this, to consume. Thus, with your mouth, you have boasted against me, and have multiplied your words against me. I have heard them. Right, they said they God, they put themselves up as God, they put themselves up as King David, and so forth. Thus said the Lord God, when the whole earth rejoice, I will make thee desolate. So what has to happen? Esau, the Edomites, have to be put out of power, and the whole world gonna rejoice, because the wicked who did the iniquity on the earth is Esau, the white man, and is coming to fruition. As thou did rejoice at the inheritance of the house of Israel, because it was desolate, so will I do unto thee. Thus shall be desolate, O Mount Seir, and all Idumea. See that? And that's the Greek way of saying it. Idumea. Even all of it, and they shall know that I am the Lord. Okay. With this Obadiah. See, because this is an ongoing struggle back and forth between two characters. And that's what this is all about. Esau and Jacob. Everybody else is extras in the movie. So get used to y'all roles. Just sit back and watch the show. It's Obadiah. We'll start at 1-1. Division of Obadiah. Thus said the Lord God concerning Edom. See that? Edom. See that? The mystery of iniquity. We have heard a rumor from the Lord. An ambassador is sent among the heathen. Arise ye, and let us rise up against her in battle. Who we gonna use? The Russians, the big bigger. Behold, I have made thee small among the heathens. Thou art greatly despised. And America has been on a, international business when it comes to dealing with their interests in other countries, their foreign affairs. And because of their foreign affairs and the way they go about bringing war, death, and destruction to the world, they are now being identified as the problem on earth. Behold, I have made thee small among the heathen, and thou art greatly despised. The pride of thy heart hath deceived thee, thou that dwelleth in the cliff of the rocks, who habitation is high. So when you go through process of illumination, who actually built all these skyscrapers and live up in these high buildings to look upon down on everybody? Esau, the white man. And America is the number one, how could I say it? They the number one portrayer of this type of spiritual trait. Thus said in thou heart, who shall bring me down to the ground? Though thou exalt thyself as the eagle. And when you go back to the Roman Empire, all the way to today, America, Britain, France, what they all carried, the eagle. What was Roman carrying? The eagle. This is Rome all over again. Look at the building, the architect. And thou that sit thou nest among the stars, this is the satellite. Then shall I bring thee down, saith the Lord. If these came to thee, if robbers by night, how art thou cut off? Would they have not stolen till they had had enough? You saw it on good enough. He's been on the same war campaign of robbing, stealing everybody's resources. If the grape gatherers came to thee, would they have not left some grapes? How are the things of Esau searched out? How are his hidden things sought up? And thanks to the Europe and the Thorum, everything is coming out and being flourished into the world. Ask me, Julius. All the men of thy confederacy have brought thee even to the border, them all the ones that do trade agreements with Esau, the white man, starting with America. That's why in 1776, May 1st, Adam Weishaupt and those Illuminatis came over here to set up this place as the beacon of light for their enterprise. The men that were at peace with thee have deceived thee and prevailed against thee. They have eaten thou bread and bled a wound under thee. There is none understanding in him. The bread is the USA, and that wound is going to be my CBM message. Shall I not in that day, said the Lord, even destroy the wise man of Edom and understanding out the mouth of Esau, and the almighty man Otima, Chimes, shall be dismayed to the end that every one of the mouth of Esau may be cut off by slaughter. So we coming down to the final stretch, coming off that third base, coming into home base, that Esau finna get. Esau may be cut off by slaughter. For thou violence against thy brother Jacob, same shall cover thee, and thou shalt be cut off forever. And his shame is what? Slavery. His institutions that he built to demonize us. Him stripping of our nationality, our culture, our heritage, dividing tribes up amongst each other, putting us in a slum and ghetto, and going on an economic war campaign on us. In the day that thou stoodest on the other side, in the day that the strangers came carry away captives his forces and foreigners into his gate and cast lots upon Jerusalem, even thou was one of them. But thou shouldest not have looked on the day of thy brother in the day he became a stranger, neither shouldest thou have rejoiced over the children of Judah. Yeah, because they rejoiced when they got us in them in that Atlantic slave trade. In the day of their destruction, neither shouldest thou have spoken proudly in the day of distress. Thou shouldest not have entered into the gates of my people in the day of their calamity. Yea, thou shouldest not have looked on their affliction in the day of their calamity, nor have laid hands on their substance in the day of their calamity. Neither shouldest thou have not stood in the crossway to cut off those of his that did escape. And that's going back into the ancient world. See that? Because you weren't just sitting around when the Assyrians came in to take the northern kingdom away. You weren't just sitting around when the Babylonians came in and take the southern kingdom away. See that? Your ass was right there making it happen too. Upon they remain their strength. For the day of the Lord is near upon all the heathen. As thou hast done, it shall be done unto thee. Thy reward shall return upon thy own head. Right, so I'm going to cut it right there. Let's go to John. See that? Because I know y'all wondering, like, how we get all this back. That's how we got it back. See that? The mystery of iniquity. There's already in the book. That's why this came. It's John 14 and 26. But the Comforter, which is Yahweh Shah, which is the Holy Ghost, which is the Spirit of truth, whom the Father, Yahweh, will send in my name, Yahweh Shah, he shall teach ye all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. See that? So in 2 Thessalonians 2 and 7 through 8, he said the wicked of iniquity has already basically did his work. And that's why the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, Yahweh Shah, is bringing this back to our remembrance on who, what, when, how, and why. The matter is what it is. This is John 16 and 13. Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. And that's why we flood the internet with all this truth and atrocities of Esau, the other nations, and what's finna happen. Prophecy. for he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. And that's why we go into prophecy, and that's why we know we're living in a time when the prophets coming back to prophesy again in their lives. Okay. Now this last one, Baruch 2 and 28. Luke 2 and 28, as thou speakest by thy servant Moses in the day when thou didst command him to write the law before the children of Israel, saying, and that's the Deuteronomy 28, the curses and the blessings, if you will not hear my voice, surely this very great multitude shall be turned into a small number among the nations where I will scatter thee. And we are looking for the elect chosen. For I know that they would not hear me, because of their stiff-necked people, but in the land of their captivity, they shall remember themselves. And that's what y'all witnessing right now. Me even doing this lesson and putting this lesson up, that's me remembering myself. Who am I? I'm a Hebrew Israelite from the 12 tribes of Israel, from the tribe of Judah. And my forefathers are Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and they was given a promise. And our enemies is all the other nations, starting off with the number one nation, Edom, or Idawam. And shall know that I am the Lord their God, for I will give them a heart, meaning a mind, and ears to hear. And that's why he say, my flock hear me, and they only follow me. And that's Yahweh Shah in this book. And they shall praise me in the land of their captivities, and think upon my name, Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah. And return from their stiff necks and from their wicked deed, for they shall remember the way of their fathers. And that's why I just gave you my lineage. You identify who my forefathers are, which sinned before the Lord, and understand why we are in this condition that we are in today. And that's having the conclusion to the whole matter. So wait ye upon me, and I shall rise you up to the prey. And I will bring them again into the land which I promised with an oath unto their fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and they shall be lords of it. And I will increase them, and they shall not be diminished. And I will make an everlasting covenant with them to be their God, and they shall be my people. And I will no more drive my people of Israel out of their land that I have given them. And with that, I'm going to say something.